Meni je čast da predstavim jednog specijalnog gosta kako u mojoj emisiji, tako danas i u našem gradu. U pitanju je gost iz Indije, Swami Vaishampayan, indijski majstor, jedan od vodećih instruktora fondacije Art of Living. Dobro večer i dobro mi došli.
Good evening and welcome.
Thank you.
I Nataša Đerek ispred fondacije Art of Living.
Yes.
Dobro mi došla.
Hvala.
Eto, vaša je zasluga što ste sami ja doveli u Subotici. U Suboticu večeras će se on predstaviti i našim sugrađanima u 19 sati na sceni Jadran Narodnog pozorišta.
Jeste, pozivamo sve građane, ukoliko imaju slobodnog vremena, da dođu od 7 sati, besplatno je predavanje, da poslušaju evo šta s vama ima da kaže. On je, kako ste ga najavili, senior instruktor ove fondacije, putuje po mnogim zemljama Evrope i trenutno, znači, prva stanica mu je Subotica, sutra već putuje dalje za Rumu, pa za Niš, pa onda za Beograd, tako da ostaće u Srbiji nedelju dana i mi smo srećni što možemo da ga ugostimo i da poslušamo što on ima da nam kaže, kako da vodimo harmonični, srećni život uz pomoć joge.
Svakako, uz pomoć meditacije, joge i pravilnog disanja, s vami kaže da možemo imati harmoničan, zdrav i sretan život.
With the help of yoga and breathing, we can have a much harmonious life and
yes.
much happier life.
Yes, yes.
That's what you're yes. talking about.
Exactly. So, you know, our whole system is made up of 7 different layers.
Znate, naš ceo sistem je napravljen od 7 različitih nivoa.
So, if you really want to be happy in your life, there should be harmony in all 7 layers.
Ako zaista želite biti srećni u životu, treba da postoji harmonija između ovih 7 nivoa.
So, our existence is made up of our body, breath, mind, intellect, memory, ego and self.
Znači, to su tih 7 nivoa postojanja.
Dakle, da spomenemo disanje, intelekt, ego, znači, yes. svojstvo.
Yes.
Ja sam zaboravila još sve. Yeah.
Body, breath,
telo,
mind,
mind,
then intellect,
intellect,
memory,
memoria,
ego,
ego
and self.
Svojstvo, je tako?
Sobstvo.
Yeah, sobstvo,
consciousness. So when you are having the harmony in all of these layers, then only you can really celebrate your life.
I kada postoji harmonija između svih tih nivoa, tek onda možemo proslavljati svoj život.
Koliko je teško uspostaviti harmoniju u ovih svih 7 nivoa? Dakle, zaista ovako kada se to nabroji, deluje prilično teško.
When you count these 7 layers, it looks like it's hard to achieve this harmony. How it is hard to achieve?
No, it is not really, because, you know, everyone is having our existence, these all 7 layers in our existence. So it is not really difficult. Just we need to understand about that.
Mm-hmm. Zaista to u stvari, u suštini nije teško, samo to treba da razumemo. Jer u svom postojanju imamo tih, znači...
No, with having little bit of awareness, you can very easily do, no, you can be very easily in the harmony with all of this.
Mm-hmm. Samo sa nekom povećanom svesnošću možemo lako biti u harmoniji u ovim 7 nivoima.
Da li to možemo da učinimo ili sebi pomognemo sa jogom, meditacijama ili disanjem?
Can we have that with the help of yoga, with meditation
exactly.
and
yes.
breathing?
Yes. So rather we need to practice yoga, meditation and breath to bring this harmony only.
Mm-hmm. Da, da bismo doveli sebe u ovu harmoniju, treba da praktikujemo jogu, disanje i meditaciju.
With the lots of different postures, asanas, you can have a better body.
Primenom različitih asana, vežbanjem tih yoga poza, dovodimo u bolje stanje svoje telo.
With the breathing techniques, you can have a harmony in your breath, mind and intellect.
Uh-huh. A sa tehnikama disanja dovodimo u harmoniju svoje
breath,
svoj dah
mind,
i svoj
intellect.
Um i intelekt.
And with the meditation, you can get the harmony in your memory, ego and self.
Da, a sa meditacijom harmoniju, u harmoniju dovodimo ego,
sobstvo.
So basically yoga is the combination of all, where we are having some body exercises also, some breathing technique also and meditation also.
Znači u jogi to sve imamo, ove tri stvari koje smo pomenuli zaokruženo.
Ljudi se često odlučuju da počnu sa yoga vežbama, međutim to im nekako deluje preteško za sam početak, pa često ima tu i odustanaka. Dakle, da li dolazi do samog poremećaja ili do nekog odupiranja sopstva ili iz nekog drugog razloga se odustaje?
We can see that occasionally people are starting yoga, but then they are leaving it aside and not practicing anymore. And why it is happening?
Because with the yoga, many times you are getting instant results.
Jer mnogo puta sa jogom dobijate instant rezultate.
So after getting that instant result, sometimes people may feel, oh okay, now I got it.
I nekad nakon malo praktikovanja joge već dobijete ono poboljšanje, kažete, aha, evo, to je to. Dobro.
So people feel, no, I have already achieved the bliss of my mind, no?
Da, već sam doživeo neki procvat svog uma.
But you know, it is always better to be in a practice. It is like a taking bath every day.
Ali bolje je biti u toj praksi svakidašnjoj kao kada se svaki dan kupamo.
So with the bath you can keep your body healthy, no? So with the practices you can keep your mind also healthy.
Znači sa kupanjem održavamo svoje telo zdravim i čistim, a sa vežbom joge um.
Yes.
Što se tiče samih mlađih generacija, dakle mladi ljudi, deca, ukoliko ih na vreme naučimo da praktikuju jogu, meditaciju i svakako pravilno disanje, da ostane ono što su dobili sa rođenjem, koliko možemo biti sigurni da ćemo imati jednu sretnu naciju?
If we start at the beginning with our youth and introduce them yoga and these breathing techniques, how we can be sure that, and can we be sure that we will have better nation in future?
Yes, I think so. This can be a very good idea. If we introduce yoga and such techniques in the beginning of the life.
Mm-hmm. Mislim da je to veoma dobra ideja, ako bi se ove tehnike yoga već učile na početku školovanja.
You know, with the yoga, they can have a better body, clarity of the mind.
Mogu imati uz pomoć joge bolje fizičko telo, zdravije i bolji intelekt i koncentraciju.
Their intellect will be very sharp and focused.
Intelekt će im biti u stvari fokusiran i oštri, puno oštri.
So if the youth, they are having a good healthy body, focused mind and sharp intellect, then that country will be really nice, no?
Da. Ako nam omladina ima te kvalitete, znači dobro telesno stanje, oštar um, intelekt, onda stvarno je država.
And you know, if you want to achieve some career also, you need a lots of energy.
Iako hoćete da postignete karijeru u svom životu, treba vam puno energije za to.
So if they start practicing from the childhood, then they know how to have a more energy to achieve something.
Iako već od detinjstva počnemo da vežbamo ove programe, možemo da dobijemo više energije koja nam je potrebna da bismo postigli neku karijeru.
So in that case also yoga is very helpful.
Za te stvari je stvarno yoga zaista.
Putovali ste po mnogim državama u našem okruženju, tu je i Makedonija, Bosna, Nemačka, Mađarska. Da li su to sretne države? Koliko je tamo zastupljena yoga, koliko se meditira i koliko se pravilno diše?
You visited all these countries in the region, Macedonia, Bosnia, Hungary, Germany even. How they are in their practice, are they happier in their lives, and are they practicing?
You know, believe me, in all over the world, nowadays people, they are too much in the stress.
Znate, verujte mi, svugde u svetu, gde god odem, ljudi su previše u stresu.
And you know, in every country, they are looking for, no, what to do so we can out of the stress.
I u svakoj državi se u stvari trude da pronađu način kako da izađu iz tog stresa.
Okay, so everywhere in the all whole of the world, people know they are really practicing yoga just to get out of the stress.
U celom svetu u stvari zaista vidimo da mnogi ljudi praktikuju jogu samo da bi se oslobodili od stresa.
So it hardly matters they are from Germany or Hungary or Bosnia or Macedonia. Everyone know they need something to handle their own stress, their own mind.
Bez obzira iz koje su zemlje, znači svakom to treba.
Stres je uvek stres.
Stres je uvek stres.
Exactly. So everywhere people are practicing and now they are realizing that, no? With the help of yoga, they are having a better life, better quality of the life.
I sada svugde se polako shvata da uz pomoć joge možemo imati bolji život, kvalitetniji život.
Ljudi su uglavnom usredsređeni na ono loše u njihovim životima, a to je taj, eto, uvek nezaobilazni stres, bilo na poslu, u saobraćaju, kod kuće, finansijska situacija. Koliko je teško se usredsrediti na jogu i na meditaciju i uopšte početi raditi te vežbe pored svih ovih problema koje ste sreli u svim državama koje ste obišli?
How it is actually this start happening when we are so concerned on our job, public transport, everywhere. We are so much in stress and occupied, and how we actually start to think about you.
That's why it is needed.
Zato sam ja potreban ovde.
Because you are so much in stress, no? Then see, if the stress is too much, then it will start reflecting on your body also.
Ako vam je prevelik stres, u stvari će se to oslikati na stanje vašeg tela.
Now, in medical science, no, they say maximum diseases are psychosomatic.
U medicini današnjoj, većina bolesti je psihosomatična.
Psychosomatic means the root cause of almost all diseases are stress.
Da. A to znači da nam je uzrok svake neke bolesti u stvari u stresu.
You know, so how you said we are now having too much of stress every day in the life, that's why yoga is very much important.
I zbog tog prevelikog stresa koji imamo u svakodnevnom životu, zato je ovo jako.
And you know, with the simple techniques of, with few pranayam, sudarshan kriya, we are having a very beautiful technique, we call it sudarshan kriya in art of living.
U art of livingu imamo jako jednu vrednu tehniku disanja koja se zove sudarshan kriya.
So with the help of that, no, you can very easily handle the stress in the life.
I pomoću te tehnike jako brzo i lagano možemo da kontrolišemo
stres. That technique will give you lots of energy, harmony in the whole system. So because of that your life can really be a celebration.
I ta tehnika daje u stvari puno otpuštanja tog stresa i čini da vam život procveta i bude prosto.
Vi ste nekako pravi primjer da neko slavi život. Međutim, evo, prošetali ste se ulicama, pretpostavljam, našeg grada. Da li možete da vidite nekog ko delimično liči na vas?
You can really say that you are, we can really say that you are celebrating your life.
Yes.
But you have walked through our city, and can you say that you met somebody like you that is also celebrating his life?
Yes, why not? Because I know everywhere people, some people, they really know how to celebrate their life. It is not like that, no? no one in the world other than me is celebrating the lives.
Da,
nije zaista tako da samo ja prostavljam svoj život. Postoje ljudi koji umeju svugde gde god odem da prostavljaju svoj život.
Ili bi želeli da to bude tako i da se nekako unaprede neka svoja znanja koja imaju.
Or they are willing to do that, or to be like you. Yes. And
definitely, everyone can be, no, everyone can have this beautiful knowledge.
Mm-hmm. It is. Stvarno, svako može da ima ovo predivno znanje.
Okay, it is not so difficult also.
Nije uopšte tako.
So with the having a little bit awareness about our own self, we can achieve that very easily. Not is a difficult task.
Samo uz pomoć malo veće svesnosti onome šta smo mi u stvari, ko smo mi u stvari, možemo to vrlo lako dostići.
E sad, verovatno, ne znam da li će danas, to je večeras, biti postavljanje pitanja, ali ono što bi ja postavila jeste šta smo mi u stvari?
I don't know if today in the evening will be a question session, an answer session, but I would like to ask what we are actually, who we are.
You know, beautifully, our founder, master, no? The Art of Living founder, Sri Sri Ravi Shankarji, he said once very nicely, life is enthusiasm, life is love, and life is joy.
Znači, život je entuzijazam, život je ljubav i život je radost. To su poruke našeg osnivača, Sri Ravi Shankara, koji je osnovao ovu fondaciju.
So, in reality, we are, no, in core of our nature, we are enthusiasm, love and joy.
U osnovi, naša stvarna priroda, naša prava priroda u unutrašnjosti svakog bića je entuzijazam, ljubav i radost.
Šta vas uglavnom ljudi pitaju, kao ih savjet ili šta ono najpre traže? Dakle, da li je to neko instant oslobađanje od stresa, pitanje koje vam često postavljaju kada putujete?
What are questions that you are most asked when you're traveling? Instant relief of stress or what?
Yes, yeah. Many people, they really would like to know how to celebrate life all the time.
Da, većina ljudi želi u stvari da zna kako da proslavlja svoj život svo vrijeme.
And jokingly, many times I tell people, okay, just do the Art of Living program and you will come to know.
Ja se našalim pa kažem, samo uradite program Art of Livinga i sve će vam biti jasno.
Yeah, because everyone of this world, they would like to celebrate their life. This is the main, no, thing they are looking for.
Svako u stvari u svijetu želi da slavi svoj život, da bude radosno, da bude srećan. To je glavna stvar koju svi želi.
So just for celebration, no, they are waiting for their birthdays, for the Christmas, for the summer holidays.
A nekad da bi uopšte slavili, čekamo rođendane, čekamo Božić, čekamo Uskrs, čekamo razne prilike.
So people, they are just, no, waiting for some occasions where they can say, okay, now this is the occasion, that's why we want to celebrate in our life.
Mm-hmm. I sada je prilika, znači kad čekamo tu neku rođendansku ili neku drugu priliku, sada je prilika da slavim život.
But you know, with the help of spirituality, with the help of yoga, you can celebrate your life in each and every moment.
Ali uz pomoć joge, možemo da proslavljamo svoj život svakog pojedinog trenutka.
Svakako, joga nije čarobni štapić da će nam otkloniti sve ono nagomilano i stresno i neke težnje koje imamo u svojoj glavi, ali zaista moramo dugo praktikovati, ili to sve zavisi od osobe do osobe.
Is it that yoga is like magic? That we have to apply, or it depends personally on the personality when it will start to function.
No, with everyone, each of us, we are having the same nature, okay?
Mm-hmm. Svako od nas ima istu prirodu.
So in everyone's life, for sure, yoga will do some magics.
Mm-hmm. Tako da u svačijem životu, u stvari, yoga će da uradi neku magiju.
Because everyone is having body, everyone is having mind, everyone is having intellect.
svako ima i telo, i um, i intelekt.
So when all these layers are healthy, you know, they are functioning nicely, properly, then in everyone's life the celebration can happen.
I kada su ovi nivoji u harmoniji i funkcionišu kako treba, tada taj nečiji život zaista je proslao.
Dobre, ajde da kažemo neki desetak godina, nije bilo toliko puno yoga instruktora, evo konkretno u našem gradu, sad ih na svu sreću ima skoro u svakom i fitness centru, nadam se da će ih biti još više, ali još jedno zanimljivo pitanje je što vidim puno yoga instruktora, a na jogu praktikuju uglavnom žene.
I saw in last 10 years the development of yoga, and much more yoga instructors are coming. But I also can notice that mostly women are in yoga.
No, it is not like that, because all over the world I can see men and women, they are actively participating in yoga.
Ja širom sveta vidim da podjednako.
To su sad izjednačali.
So, initially, I think so, in Europe especially, the people were thinking that yoga is something more about the physical flexibility.
Uh-huh. A na zapadu je u stvari tako počeo da su ljudi pomislili da je yoga nešto što se bavi telesnom fleksibilnošću.
So, many times, you know, women, they are taking more care of their body. So maybe just to be fit or in a shape, earlier maybe it was there, so more women you can see in the yoga. Mm-hmm.
I to je onaj prvi, jel da, korak, kada žene u stvari su one koje više brinu o svom telu, pa su nekako kroz to više ušle u jogu.
But now people, they are realizing that yoga is not just about body.
Ali danas ljudi više uviđaju da yoga nije samo briga o telu.
So now you can find everyone here, no? From kids to old people, women, men, everyone is.
Nadam se da će tako biti u našem gradu. Kod nas još uvijek nekako više žene, evo Nataša samo.
Da. She hopes that it will be so in our city as well, because in our city currently are
more than I say.
Ljudi najčešće odustaju od joge kada vide na televiziji, u medijima osobe koje se savijaju, koje rade razne pokrete sa svojim telom. Dakle, to svakako nije samo joga, savitljivost tela, nego jednostavno uspostavljanje nekog balansa između duha i tela.
Da. People are
to ne treba da nas
somehow afraid when they saw on television hard postures of yoga and then that it is flexibility, yes. Body flexibility. Yes.
You know, it is just one part of yoga. Mm-hmm.
To je samo deo yoga.
Okay, so no need to bother, no need to know. Having this fear that, oh, is it for us or not?
To ja
ne treba, ne treba imati to zabrinuće. Tu brigu da li je to za mene ili da li ću to moći.
Okay, everyone can do, everyone can practice, no? It
svako
is not
to
so
može.
Difficult.
Nije uopšte to toliko teško, svako to može.
Da, stavi nogu iza glave, teško, ali svakako može taj osnovni deo uspostavljanje tog balansa, je li tako? Recite mi koliko yoga se vežba stalno, dakle tokom čitavog života kada je upoznate, jednostavno ostanete njene ljubitelji, konstantno je vežbate. Koliko je potrebno vremena da se uspostavi kompletan balans duha i tela?
How much time is actually needed to achieve this balance of body and the spirit?
It is a practice, believe me. It is not like that you can just practice yoga for 10 days, 1 month, 1 year and you will get it.
To nije samo ono vežbom jogu jedan mesec, pola godine, godinu dana i sad sam to. To
so,
je stvar prakse.
It is like asking that in for how many days I need to eat food so build I can build a nice body.
Uh-huh. To je kao da pitamo koliko dana treba da jedem neku dobru hranu da bi imao savršeno telo.
No, you need to have food for whole of your life, then only your body will be fit.
Da, treba da uzimaš takvu hranu celog svog života pa će ti telo biti u dobroj formi.
So same, you need to keep practicing yoga, no? So all the time your body, your mind will be fit.
Uh-huh. Zato u stvari trebamo praktikovati jogu svaki dan da bi nam telo i um bili u dobroj formi.
Kako da naučite da proslavite svoj život u pravom smislu, možete naučiti i večeras, dakle u 19. časova, scena Jadra Narodnog pozorišta.
Jeste, besplatno, ulaz, svi su dobrodošli.
Ja bih samo zamolila Svamija za jednu poruku za kraj za naše sugrađane.
One last message for our citizens.
Just celebrate your life, okay? Yoga is a celebration. It is not just a physical exercise. Yoga is learning how to celebrate our life each and every moment. So just loads of love to everyone and just keep smiling and celebrating your life. Thank you very much.
Samo proslavljajte svoj život. Yoga vas uči tome. Znači, ostanite uz osmeh i proslavite svoj život svakog pojedinačnog trenutka.
Hvala vam puno.
Thank you very much.